What are the things missing in my life? For some, it's skills. For some, there are visions in your careers, your business, in your spiritual life, in your ministry, in your family, your personal life, your goals. Some people complain in their companies that they are not growing. You need to retool. You need to rekit. Sometimes God needs to completely break you into pieces and make you afresh. Because there are things in your life that are not compatible with the vision. And you must drop them first. And one of that was Lot. Abraham carried Lot. And Lot became a problem to him. Even after they separated, he still needed to go. Lot went into Sodom. Abraham had to go and rescue him. And a lot of issues. What are the baggages in your life that you need to get rid of? Friends, are there people around you that don't even believe in where you are going to? But when you tell them what you plan to achieve, they tell you are joking. They tell you that it's not possible. Think well. Think calm. It isn't na beans. People don't believe in you. People, you tell what's your vision and they laugh. You can see impossibility. You can see limitation written in their eyes. They are not the right people in your journey. Are there people in your journey that don't need to be there? Are there? There are people who have had visions of doing mighty and great things for God. And they married a spouse who has said, "Kakaka, me and ministry, I'm not interested in ministry." And they started and everything crumbled. For some have lost their marriages because of their I personally know people whose marriages have failed because of ministry. They married somebody who felt ministry was out of the question. They were not interested. Before you marry, you did not tell me you are going to be a pastor. So what is this that we are doing? So you need to surround yourself with people that will enable you to succeed. People who believe in where you are headed for. Another thing is courage. You see what Joshua did? He said, when they finally heard this advice of the whole camp of Israel, they were afraid, they were disheartened. And Caleb and Joshua said, no. Caleb and Joshua said, no. He said, we are well able. We will take over the land. We will take over the country. We know that the giants are there. Don't lie to yourself that the giants are not there. Courage is not positive thinking. It's not looking at the mirror and saying, I will make it. Forget about that. Saying nice things in the mirror and smiling at yourself and adjusting your jacket does not take you there. You have to have a fair, honest assessment of your limitation and work with God to fix it. For some people, it is sleep. They just need to take care of the spirit of sleep. For some people, it's friends. There are people in your life that have no business being in your life, and they are still there. And they are still there. Another thing you experience in your vision, you see, Abraham started his journey not knowing where he was going to. When he got to a stop, a king looked at his wife. I don't know how you would look at a woman that is almost 90 years old. And I don't know what, I mean, she must have been very hot. You know, I'm talking to youth, so we can talk like young people. I mean, I can imagine what she looked at 25 or 30. If at about 90, Abimelech saw her and snatched her from her husband, Whatever Abraham was doing, I need to find out.